You've probably heard the saying that despite all the visual differences we see between people, we all bleed the same blood. Well, yes and no. Like so many things in life, there are nuances or differences when you actually get down to it. And that brings us to the idea of blood types or blood groups. Now, to be sure, you cannot tell the differences between blood types and blood groups based on a person's skin color, for instance, or a person's hair texture. These are not shortcuts to knowing what blood group an individual has. There are a total of 33 different classification systems for blood that has been recognized. But the two that you need to worry about, because it is clinically relevant, are the ABO system, Rh system. Before we get into the nitty-gritties, a bigger picture. So there are a bucket load of antigens on the surfaces of cells, and blood cells are no exception. Why do we call them antigens? Because they generate antibodies. Why do they generate antibodies? Because the body recognizes that they do not belong to it. That is, they are foreign. And in time, your immune system is potentially going to go wild and problems can happen. A blood type refers to the presence or absence of a certain marker or antigen on the surface of a person's red blood cells. For example, in the ABO system, presence of a B antigen gives the blood type as type B. The presence of an A antigen on the surface of the red blood cell classifies that blood type as an A blood type. And the presence of both antigens, and yes, you can have, there are in some individuals where both antigens are present on their red blood cells, these ones are classified as type A and B. There are also individuals where there are no antigens on the surfaces of the blood cells, and these are type O. And these tend to be called the universal donors in some parts of the world. Once we get into the Rh system, you'll see that if you are an O positive, then you're not necessarily universal in certain parts of the world. But generally, an O blood type is universal in that they don't have these antigens that can generate antibodies, and therefore they can give to all. And I, who speak to you right now, I am the generous type. I am an O blood type. But of course, that kind of sucks because it means that when I need blood, I can only take from someone who is also an O, because since I don't have any A or B antigens in on the surfaces of my blood, if you give me blood that is A, my body's gonna say, that is not the blood type we've got going on here, and my immune system will react. Likewise, if you give me a B blood type, a blood subtype, my blood is gonna say, sorry, we don't have any B antigens on our surfaces. Why is there B antigens floating around? And my body will attack that particular antigen. So as you can see, blood type is critical for blood transfusion, as these specific antigens must match between a donor and a recipient for safe transfusion. The rule is simple. Patients should not be giving antigens that their own blood does not have. This is because the recipient's immune system may recognize any new antigen as foreign and develop antibodies to target for destruction. So depending on the scale of the triggered immune response, the reaction can be serious or even fatal. So applying the rule, so someone with B will also only be able to receive blood type from another one with B. Someone with AB, well, they've got both. So you can give them A, it will be okay. You can give them B, it will be okay. Someone with O, like myself, can only receive O antigen. Now, in some parts of the world, the Rh system, which the Rh really just stands for rhesus monkey, and it's just rhesus monkey because that's where the initial research was discovered, so we just got that name. But basically, this is another antigenic system, where your body can develop antibodies against a D antigen. But it's not already there. You kind of have to be exposed to it first. So the first contact, you're probably going to be okay. But then if you face it again, your body's like, oh, we've seen this before. Just like an infection, we say, we've seen this before. It doesn't belong to us. Then it will attack it. So unlike the ABO system where your body's already got antigens, like by the time you're one, it's already developed it. The RH system is more of like a responsive system. And so how do you check for compatibility? There are tests you can do in the lab to work out what type of blood group you are dealing with. You will need your drop of blood, which has been mixed in a blood tube. You're gonna need antibodies against that blood. So you're gonna have antibodies to A, B, and RH, the antigen D. And then you're also gonna have pasture pipettes just to collect the blood, and a stick just to mix the blood. And so what you're going to do is put a drop of the patient's blood, then introduce antibodies against that, against A in one spot, against B in another spot, and against D antigen. And you're really looking for clumping. And so you tell you if the person is A, B, or have the RH positive or RH, the D antigen expressed. And you want to know the D antigen is expressed because, like I said, in a minority of individuals, it can actually be catastrophic if they are RH negative, but they get RH positive blood. However, for RH positive people, they can take RH negative blood and there's no issue. The RH factor can become really problematic during pregnancy if the woman is RH negative while the baby is RH positive. So if blood cells from the baby travel across the placenta, the woman's immune system will see the RH positive cells as a threat. Specialized white blood cells will make antibodies designed to kill RH positive blood cells. If the woman later conceives another RH positive baby, her immune system is primed, it's ready, and will flood the fetus with antibodies. These antibodies then destroy the baby's red blood cells. You can see that's going to be problematic. So if left untreated, this can result in severe anemia for the baby and even death. This disease is called hemolytic disease of the newborn. It can be prevented. So as routine in developed countries, RH negative mothers who have babies or fetuses that are known to be RH positive are immunized throughout their pregnancy and within 72 hours of giving birth using an immunoglobulin made from donated blood products. So immunoglobulin being antibodies. And these antibodies breaks down the baby's red blood cells inside the mother's bloodstream before the immune system has time to react. So that brings us to the end of this video. Super fascinating learning all about blood types. And if you want to join the study group and hear about more topics like these, then please give my video a thumbs up. Join the study group by subscribing. So how did we get to learn all this about blood types and the differences? Well, that's a whole long story, super fascinating story that deserves its own video. So I won't cover it here, but suffice it to say that Carl Landestein is the researcher most recognized for this type of work, as he followed obsessively his interest, his curiosity around why some people could receive blood transfusion and thrive while others succumbed or were really not doing well. And by following it, he was able to kind of see the different types, to identify and categorize the different types and identify that it was these antigens on the surfaces of the red blood cell. But again, that's like a totally different video in its own right. So fascinating. In the next video, God bless. Bye.